שלום לכם, אנחנו בישיבת כתבים.
Hello and welcome to the writers' meeting with Dr. Michael Laitman. Hello. Hello, everyone. And 3 weeks to go to the beginning of the school year, nothing's closed. No one knows what's going to happen. Still thoughts, maybe we should postpone the opening from fourth grade and on after the holidays. And I'll give 60 seconds about what's going on from the point of view of the Ministry of Education, the teachers, and so on. The Minister of Education, he thinks that we're not ready for distance learning. Parents, students, teachers have many technical problems and helplessness. The teachers themselves, they don't know how to reinforce obedience, or they don't know how to work with the students, and the teachers don't know why do they have to work so hard. Some of them have children that are learning from home. Some of them are losing their jobs to teachers that are not trained. This week, the recruit of 13,000 new teachers, the Ministry of Education started recruiting 13,000 new school teachers because the classes were split into smaller classes, smaller classrooms, and because many of the teachers have no training, it comes at the expense of teachers that do have training, and that caused lots of tension. The parents themselves, they have to stay at home with their children that are learning from home. Every child needs a quiet corner and a computer of his own. And with the younger children, for the parents, it's practically impossible to sit a child down in front of the computer and start studying online. And the students themselves have zero motivation. They feel that they can't learn virtually. The students are bored, don't like it, no one studies. The situation is painful, in short. No one knows what's going to happen. Everyone's worried about the future, and there's one big chaos. We'd like to try and identify the opportunity behind all of this, and a more general question, what is this helplessness? What can this helplessness teach us? It can teach us one thing, one big thing, that the entire our entire educational system was built about 200 years ago, at least 150 years ago, and its purpose was to take people, not children, but grown-ups, to take grown-ups that came from villages, farmers, and to quickly train them, give them a few classes, in order for them to become workers, for them to be able to work with steel, wood, different things, so they can read a diagram, work plan, a few words. That they're told to, for them to know, you know, basic math, things that children learn over a period of 2, 3, maybe 4 years. This was intended, this was what school was intended for, which was supposed to take farmers and turn them into industrial workers, to know how to work with machines, the machines that we had back there, and so on. Over time, this method did not change. Also, children are sitting in front of their teacher, and the teacher is telling them different things. And they sit and somehow listen, more or less. Everyone eventually leaves school. No one stays there. And this is what happens. We have now reached a state that's so advanced in terms of our education, culture, inner development, media, that it's all in the reach of children, that children know better than us how, with the help of the media, to find what they want, movies, they correspond, they're in control of everything. So, I don't understand how come those that are in the Ministry of Education think that it is impossible to teach children through the media, through the internet. This is something that I don't understand, because in every home today, to the contrary, there's proof that children are learning. This is how they're actually learning. And in school, they're not learning anything. That's it. And so I don't see that there's a matter here of any kind of hardship to teach children, but our hardship is to teach teachers and parents how to correctly teach children. From all these factors, who can make the change? Ministry of Education, parents, students, who? Politicians. The politicians use it like anything else in society. That pains society. Politicians use it in order to exploit their opponents. It's not to the benefit of the children, parents, the educational system itself, nothing. But each of them only solely to their own benefit. The hardship is that they're trying to shove the old system into the internet. Sure, children can do it, but the problem is when you take the previous form and try to put it into some kind of virtual realm, it doesn't work. Dr. Laitman, of course it doesn't work. Children learn off a computer screen very well. Only have to make the changes for them to be as good as the programs that they learn from, the games that they play, for it to interest them, for it to help them connect to these programs. It's not such a problem. If the people in the educational system will only understand that this is what's ahead, if not, then we will fail in putting together this system of acquisition of knowledge. I'm not even talking about education, because there's no education there, no matter how you look at it, not on the internet, and not physically in the Ministry of Education or anywhere, but a kind of system of acquisition of knowledge that you can quickly suit to the distance learning. One of the ideas, in order to disconnect this from politics, as you said, is that the municipalities will manage their educational system like it is in the United States, that every city will do what it sees fit. I don't think that we're made for it, that we're capable of it. I don't think that we're culturally adapted to it, that as a city we can get together and decide that we need to have things one way or another, or even if we're talking about areas. In the United States, you have very clear areas, that this is an area for these people, this is an area for those people. Here, I don't think that there's any kind of approach to this, and we're very sensitive. Why is it there one way, here it's another way? People will think that someone's trying to cheat them. I don't think we're ready for it. Here, people are very sensitive to equality. And if we're talking about equality, then everyone thinks that they're being exploited and the other is getting more than I am. I don't think that we will be able to do this. Also, we're not ready for it. How's it? In every city, now they'll start building a different method of education for themselves. So anyone who wants to be mayor will start playing around with it, that I want to make this kind of method, that kind of method. It's only, this can only exacerbate wars. What kind of cooperation should there be between the educational system, parents and students, for it to work out? I think that finally they will understand that they depend on each other, need each other, and a child that learns from home, he's not sitting on his parents' head, but that he's simply doing what he has to do from home. But he's taught by those very same teachers. And here, there's so much, we have so many ways to teach them in a good and nice way with the help of movies and recorded shows. And to give them exams and talks. You have an infinite amount of options, possibilities, opportunities, and children know how to work with that limitlessly. The way they get along and how they adapt themselves so quickly to every virtual plan or program or app. But how to awaken their motivation, because they're exposed to so many disturbances, games, this, that, on the computer. It's more interesting than English, for example. Dr. Laitman, this is a big question. This is my hope, that those that want to teach physics, math, you know, different precise sciences to children, they will have to do it in a way that it will interest children and will immediately stimulate them, that they have to answer questions and see what is going on. It won't be like it was before, formally. I gave it, and that's that. Or like history lessons, you have a list, chronological list, and it says about each of these things what that is. But you'll have to explain why, what for, and it's not a problem. This isn't something that's demanded of the teacher. The teacher here doesn't exist. There's a movie that was prepared and a correct, good way in the academy for each and every age, and a child sees it, that it was prepared for him by experts, with psychologists, that it interests him, that in the movie he really sees what's going on in history, geography, biology, zoology. Today you can do it so beautifully. Only that it has to be made in a good way. The educational system is in constant deterioration for a very long time now. No one wants to go to school. School became a place where you simply get bad examples of drugs and whatnot. I don't think that there is anything good about school the way it was, and let's hope that it'll collapse one way or another for sure. If not this year, then next year will collapse. There's no way back, because it's dead for many years now. That parents don't want to leave their children at home. The parents themselves will have to sit at home. There's no question about it. At least one of the members will have to stay at home because they'll have no work. And we already see there are even men that are willing to sit at home and women that are willing to go to work. But eventually, this is how it is. Going back to children. Okay, you can teach in different ways. Interesting, original, creative ways. Along with questions at the end of the movie. And to help him answer and make room for them to answer and immediately send the answer, and every child immediately has this notebook or some program that registers this, and we know how children are according to the area that they're in, according to the region, the area, and so on. Okay, this is a child in front of his computer. What's missing here is the social process, socializing. The social process, too, will partially be on the computer, that he participates like with the movie. He participates in certain activities where he has a group and he has to participate with it, and you have to have programs because it's not TV, it's a computer. It's somewhere that a child can't, it's something that a child can't participate in. And besides, once or twice a week, he can go to school and have a day of workshops there and to prepare himself for this day and to participate there. And the main thing is that his grades will be about how much does he participate with others. I remember from school that beyond the knowledge, you had breaks, you had games, you had plenty of things, socializing, friendship, and today you don't have that. It doesn't exist now, or it won't exist. Yeah, when we'll learn only online, then we'll become robots, I don't know. I think that today's system, from children, it is a system that's repugnant. It's all based on competition, disregard, pressure, group pressure, putting pressure on each other. I don't think that children will want to go to school, and if we'll do it twice a week, then they have a social day or something. I think that we can prepare them in a way that it will be really a day of fun with field trips, with games, with everything. So you do see most of their time virtual. Yes, they should learn virtually, not to give them too much time to walk around in the yard and to show who's stronger and who's prettier. Okay, where does the emotional process develop in addition to the intellectual process? From learning on the computer and from meeting twice a week at school for workshops. And this is enough in order to develop a child, Dr. Laitman. Yeah, because when he plays on the computer, he learns too. He has such programs in which he has to participate emotionally and to answer and to ask. And children today you don't have to talk. I mean, I see in coffee shops everywhere, wherever there are 2-3 people sitting, they talk to each other on their mobiles. They don't open their mouth. They don't hear each other. They read everything off their screen. So what are you asking about? I'm showing you what's going on in real life.
אני שואל גם כן, אתה יודע, על חבורות, התקשרויות.
I'm asking about friendships, getting together. You'll have all that, why not? Through the computer, like now, they connect with each other this way now anyway. These with those. It's something that they have enough place for gossip, for this, for that. No problem. What would you advise children to do, children that don't know how to fit in? They'll learn. Actually, the screen will help them to be a bit more distanced from others and also more connected with others. The screen actually gives people a better ability to express themselves. What is the role of the teacher in general? If I don't think that it's going to be a teacher. I think that, first of all, every school, or maybe altogether, it's going to be some general kind of school for the entire country, which is some kind of library with different lessons and whatever. And there will be a group of people working there, psychologists and teachers, but such that really understand things and work together on how can they all in all promote the entire population of children to a level, a good level, from one level to the next, to elevate them. I don't think that there's room for a teacher. There's something else. There's room, nonetheless, not even an educator, maybe, but someone that takes care of them. That still, in every city, every area, like there was a school that children went to, then the same way there is this small group of educators, let's call them, that deal with cases that awaken, that are brought up, that need to be dealt with. And the teachers themselves, what should they change in their attitude from teaching face-to-face to teaching face-to-screen? There are no such teachers, only movies. Only movies, only those things that really were thoroughly examined and correctly built and designed, and these are things that we really present to children, and everyone will have the same movies, the same things. Really, everyone will be on the same level. No problem. And there's no human factor supervising the learning, obedience. Dr. Laitman, I told you, after every 30-minute show, suppose, I don't think that it should be any longer, there are questions and answers and different things where they have to answer, they have to do something. And a human instructor, will he give them questions and answers, or is it a computer? Dr. Laitman, maybe it will be a person. We have to see. Today, they get along so well with machines that I don't think it's a problem. Dudi, so nowadays, a child doesn't need a grown-up, some instructor, flesh and blood to be in touch with him. A robot can raise him. Dr. Laitman, a child understands robots better than human beings. Dudi, because there are teachers that do affect you, give you a personal example. Dr. Laitman, dinosaurs. Dudi, okay, another question. If we do find a vaccine for the coronavirus, will the educational system go back to how it was, or are we talking about a meaningful change? Dr. Laitman, even before the coronavirus, our educational system was broken seriously, and therefore there's no point thinking about bringing it back. It's a kind of regression that there's none like it.
לא שומע, דודי.
אה, סליחה, שלי, בבקשה.
שלי, פליז.
מקודם דיברת על זה שאולי...
Previously, we talked about learning having to be based on games, on things that cause us pleasure. Can you explain a bit about the root?
כולם לומדים דרך משחקים.
Everyone learns through games. Everyone, even animals, they play. Little animals. Whenever we want to be correctly connected, we play, including a flirt between man and woman. And therefore, we need these games for children too. There are different movies, different things. We have to examine these things. We want to develop them in general. Our children. And also all the movies about math and physics. There are enough shows where it's conducted through play. I don't remember what channel I saw it on, but it's like keep it simple, stupid, something like that, and you show how to do it correctly, how to, you know, physics, chemistry games, things like that, all through play. You can do it all through play. It's clear to those that teach what has to be added here in order for children to sit with their mouth open. And if not, then that's our challenge. We have to do it. And if we do it correctly, then these plans will be recommended to all children in the world. Here we're unlimited. Here we can take from any government, any Ministry of Education, such plans and adapt them to ourselves and vice versa. We can really build what suits our generation, the integral generation, in an integral world, we can suit an integral education for everyone. And then people will better understand each other, will come closer to one another. The educational system can really become an international system that all countries work on together. Dr. Laitman, exactly, yeah. There's a stock of lessons, plans recommended by the UN, UNESCO, and so on. And this is how it should be done. Still, many people listen to you now, are listening to you now. What is there about play that stimulates? Because, Dr. Laitman, I talked about this a lot in the past, that play is a very serious thing, that we start our life with play, most of our learning, how we learn from life, not what we learn in school, comes from play, and this is why school looks as such a dry place and repugnant. We like play. Even between us. When we're talking about our relations, we too like play. And if it's not play, if it's very formal, it's more like the army, and this rejects people. Because it dries them out. So what are the main qualities required of a person that wants to be engaged in education from this day on? First of all, they have to know that they themselves have to learn. They themselves have to learn how to do it. They need to understand that they have to make something interesting out of every lesson, that along with teaching, they also draw their students to learn, to know, to make things. It should be a creative process. When I'm engaged in different exercises that I'm given, it seems to me that I'm building something. I can't explain it here, but people understand, those that are involved in education, they know what's missing. And the main thing, what I hope that they'll add is to correct learning, is how to teach children to correctly connect with one another. That's the main thing. Just to say that many educators are writing that it's already in the work. This is the direction to build a general library and to do it through play, this, that, everything that you're saying. The big question is how to connect children. How do you connect between people that are not in the same room? Who will teach connection? By putting them in workshops. We put them into these kinds of connections. What's the problem? 10 children are sitting together, for example, and each of them has a small camera. So we can arrange for them a kind of room that, just like you're sitting in front of me, I see that in front of me there are sitting 9 people now. Instead of 9, there could be 90. Doesn't matter. And we're discussing something. And there are no limitations. The main thing for us is to understand the principle. And we have no choice. This is something that we can't avoid. What is there about this form of discussion, like a workshop, that connects us? Dr. Laitman, now we're not in a workshop. We're not equal. You're attacking me, and I'm trying to answer. This isn't a workshop. A workshop is where everyone sits together in a circle, feeling that we're a part of the same topic, we're scrutinizing the same topic, and we feel that in our connection, that by our connection, it's something that we can solve things correctly through our connection. Dudi, and where will the connection between the children happen, Dr. Laitman? In the same exercises, that only together they can reach a solution. We teach them gradually. Dudi, can you give an example? Dr. Laitman, I can't. Give me some question. It has to consist of sub-questions and sub-answers, such that they will understand that actually the connection, we have to understand that the connection between everyone is what gives the solution, and not that some smart person can give a solution. What should we bring to the workshop? Social questions, current events, Dr. Laitman, everything. Even if you give them a history course in geography, doesn't matter. And then you start asking them, and they have to complete each other until they get a full story. The main thing is to show them that together they can do it. Dudi, that they all talk together equally, this builds their connection? Dr. Laitman, sure. They start appreciating each other. Dudi, how does it exactly work that we're equals? And Dr. Laitman, if we succeed together, we get a good grade for everyone. Dudi, boys, for example, don't like workshops. They like sports, running around. Girls maybe will like to sit and talk all day long, but boys, Dr. Laitman, no. Depends how you build these things. I don't think that that's how it is. This is an impression from an incorrect approach, from incorrect plans. Okay, now, learning online, it seems that it's harder to create a conversation, to create a connection. How do you do it through the net? Dr. Laitman, I see that they connect more easily via the internet than they do physically between themselves.
Mamash. They
connect more correctly through the media lines. They talk slower than they write, than they text. The direction is to make a group out of them, to build a group out of them, to give them an appreciation for the group. Not specifically that group, but to give them the appreciation of a group, of the concept of the group, so that they'll appreciate the connection that can exist between people. Not necessarily that specific group, but any other group. If there's a connection, there's some special addition. The school day has to be shorter than today? I think so.
Dude,
an average, what do you think? How long? Dr. Layton, 3-4 hours tops. And all the rest of the time, it's to give them an option of riding their bikes, going for a walk, things like that. There's enough to do. Dudi, what about discharging energy on a daily basis, sports? Dr. Laitman, that's what I just said. This has to be like one thing. A child's day has to be divided this way. Learning at home, and then they can get together, those on bicycles, those with a ball, this with this, those with that.
Okay. עדיין לא שנייה אוקיי עדיין לא ברור מה זה אומר לבנות מהם קבוצה.
Still, it's unclear what does it mean to build a group out of them, to give them the appreciation for a group. Dr. Laitman, not necessarily that they have a group, like a group of thugs against another group, but to give them an appreciation for connection during, while they learn, while they're together, hanging out, for them to appreciate the connection between people and everything, that we benefit from connection.
Shelley?
If my interaction with the friends is very minimum, and around discussions, why is it actually that, I'm speaking as a child, right? Why would I feel a need for them to do something with them? If you feel no need for them, please don't come near, because really, with your ego, when you come closer to others, you only destroy things. Suppose today I see my children with their friends. They meet, they play, they love their friends and need their friends more than they love and need me. So where will this be expressed online? Dr. Laitman, I said that it's forbidden, that it's not going to be. I only said what replaces studying in a classroom. Shelley, so they'll have to keep working on their social ties even outside screen time. Dr. Laitman, let's imagine the following state. The coronavirus is here to stay. Children come to school. It's a place where they again and again get the same disease over and over, and it's becoming more and more acute, like we see now. And what they're telling us and what they're not telling us yet. So what are you going to do? What, you think that you can do whatever you feel like? We will not be allowed to go back to the old style of school and to kindergartens and to that both parents work. Will not happen. Imagine this situation, and then what can you do? Do it. Not because you're thinking, should we, shouldn't we? But you have no choice. I'm very in favor of these changes, I wish. Dr. Laitman, I'm not talking about in favor or not. I'm saying that there's no choice. Shelley, in this intensive process, the parents too, they have to go through some kind of psychological change. Dr. Laitman, no choice about that either. Shelley, they'll go through it against their own will. Dr. Laitman, that's their own business. I'm tired of talking about these things. I don't have to prove this to anyone. I'm only saying that whether you like it or not, this is what's going to happen. Both parents are not going to work, only one parent, and children won't go to school. We see that school is becoming a place only where you catch the disease.
To
the one more form of education, we'd like to talk about the future of higher education. What's your vision in light of the corona crisis? Chaim, please. Yeah, so we prepared a few questions. Maybe the first question is, in general, do you see the existence of universities in the future? Dr. Laitman, no, no. Universities will become, are becoming political places that exacerbate hate, and I see no continuity for universities. I think that we finished with universities altogether. In the past, these were monasteries, then it became universities, and now that's it. They finish themselves off, that they allowed foreign financial support to enter universities and parties and different currents. By that, each and every university went bankrupt. Today, it's not a place for getting a degree or becoming a scientist or someone or something, but only in order to relate yourself to some kind of movement. And from year to year, it's becoming worse. Along with that, when people want to learn, study computer science or precise sciences, they still go to universities. Is there room for that, Dr. Laitman? Yes, if you clean the university of everything else besides the occupation itself. And what do you define as profession? Dr. Laitman, please, he wants to take up computer sciences, robotics, anything, please. But he wants to study a profession, and not that he goes to university where over a period of several years he's turned into a right-wing supporter, left-wing supporter, this, that. Universities have to consist of all currents. It has to be a law. History, is it not a profession? Dr. Laitman, history it is, on the one hand. On the other hand, it depends who teaches. You're right. Chaim, so what should social sciences, political sciences be like in a corrected university? Dr. Laitman, having nothing to do with any political current. Chaim, how do you do it? Dr. Laitman, this I don't know. I don't know. But this is the source for all social disputes that later come to society. Rifts. Chaim, academics nowadays have a certain status nowadays. When a person has an academic degree or he's a doctor, then he's appreciated a bit more versus someone who doesn't have some kind of title. How do you see the future in this regard? Dr. Laitman, if it will continue the way it is today, it will all collapse. It will fall. Because it will more, what will be important is you're a doctor from what university? Right wing, left wing, this, that, and then accordingly people will listen to what he says. Chaim, today academics are considered to be more developed as human beings. What is a developed human being in the new world? Dr. Laitman, I hope that everyone will be developed. It will be possible to give everyone the title of doctor. Today, doctor, the title doctor is something very narrow, only in regard to their own discipline. And I hope that in the few upcoming years, with the new learning and education, then everyone will be on such a level that they will have, that it'll be really clear to them that a person has to be a human being. That first and foremost, he has to accept every person nicely. And afterwards, it will affect his profession in terms of the current that he is a part of. We have reached a state where our society is becoming very narrow and rifted. Chaim, many positions, when they're offered, for them you need a certain degree. MA, BA, depends, there are different criteria. You have to be an academic on a certain level. Do you see this in the future too? And if so, what will they mean? Look, if we're talking about some kind of clerk in the government, I don't know, what does he need a degree for? That you have to have one in order to be accepted to a certain position. On the other hand, it doesn't say that a person did something, that he has some kind of preparation, that he knows how to get a degree. I'm in favor. Even though, that again, I'm saying that nowadays it all got such a twist in direction, in the wrong direction, in direction of how do I exploit society by that, that's a problem. That's a problem. In our time, it's all distorted. As a parent to a teenager who's a student now, I see all the opinions that he gets. Along with it, he gets skills, how to read an article, how to write an article. Dr. Leighton, this, of course, Chaim, and it's done as a part of the academic studies. There are certain skills that you get. Dr. Laitman, I'm not canceling the academy. I'm saying that we have to clean it of any political currents, extremists. Today you simply buy universities, bring a few millions, and you buy the entire university. That's the problem. Chaim, so on my part about precise sciences, I understand the bigger problem is social sciences and political sciences. Dr. Laitman, I don't think that this should be something studied in universities at all. It has to be something very in the margins. Call it a university, but that's completely unrelated to the place where you study wisdom, science. And it's also not social science. Social is social. It's not science. That also we give degrees and take history, for example. You have 1,000 historians, start asking them, you'll get 1,000 opinions. Who's right, who's not? So it's not a wisdom, it's not science.
תודה.
אנחנו נעבור ברשותך לנושא האחרון שלנו.
Our last topic for today, that's also related to education.
גני ילדים,
kindergartens. Something current that the public is really... Recently, there was a new case of kindergarten teachers in a kindergarten torturing kindergarten children. The question is, where does such evil come to a person from to hurt such vulnerable children? Dr. Laitman, it comes to a person in the most natural way because of that they behaved the way that they did. I can only blame the Ministry of Education, or I don't know exactly what does it belong to, the different government offices, that they do not prepare the right people to work with children. Another surprising thing is that it's not one kindergarten teacher, but it was an entire team. How does it spread in all of us together? Dr. Laitman, because we're living in a new era where our ego is breaking all boundaries, wanting to simply go loose. And children, so it's a place to go loose. But what causes a person who sees these things and he sits quietly and does nothing? Because he understands them. His ego works too, only not in such a way that he himself wants to discharge himself that way. It's something that exists and will exist and more, unless we take care of this in a tight way. Those mothers that soon will remain at home without work will have to, in every kindergarten or in every such framework, or they will have to take turns of duty there. I can't promise a good behavior. I can't promise any person that any person will behave properly, no matter who that is. Regardless of how many degrees he has or whatever, it's a matter of time, and our time turns every person into an animal. Personally, it's frightening in me. There's an animal that can burst out, Dr. Laitman. That can happen for sure. And even though that I know you for years, I wouldn't vouch for you in anything. I can't vouch for myself in anything. It frightens me how to restrain the animal in me. Dr. Laitman, it's general education, but in the meantime, what we need is that from morning till evening, all day long, when children are in kindergarten, that there's a representative of the parents that is there all the time, and he has to get guidance as to how to watch over everything that's happening. That's a good solution, that there will be a parent on duty every time, and it has to be someone from the parents, not someone else. Who do you trust? Dr. Laitman, no one, but the parents at least. A parent who's there, a woman that her children are there too, in kindergarten, and every day it's someone else, I can trust her at least to some extent. Meaning cameras don't convince you either. Cameras, that's an addition, have to be.
Okay. אני רק רואה שמה שקורה שאני מגלה שאני מאבד את
I see that what's happening is that I'm losing my innocence. I'm suspicious of everyone. Dr. Laitman, thank God you're growing. But where's the trust here, Dr. Laitman? No such thing, just like you said. You don't trust yourself, so what are you asking about? Dude, so I'm not relating to them as the kindergarten teacher or whoever, but it's the trust is broken, the relations. Dr. Laitman, what relations are you talking about? The relationship between two egoists and children, they're cruel too, and they also know how to aggravate you and aggravate each other. You know how these things work. You see it at home. And so until we all get a general education for all of us, this is how things are. Our future is very complicated.
Norma.
What does this tell about society? Society is advancing toward a happy end. And in order to reach that happy end, we have to understand how bad we are and how we have to change in order to come to good. So there are two things here. The good future is shining upon us. Our current state is the opposite of good, and therefore we feel bad. And here, we need a method of education for it to help us adjust or adapt ourselves to a good future. But the future is coming.
Adam, סליחה, תמשיכי. Norma.
אז המסקנות כדי לשפר את המצב?
רק חינוך כללי.
So, how can we improve things? Dr. Laitman, general education and only. General education, different government, different education, and different society, in short. The entire nation has to change. Otherwise, no one cares. You think that what happened in that kindergarten doesn't happen in other places, or maybe to a different extent, or that it's not discovered. And in nursing homes, it doesn't happen. What are you talking about? Society as a whole, all over the world, is completely destroyed. And we can't demand of the caretakers that take care of the elderly or little children. We can't demand anything of them because today people are savages, everyone, living on the verge of their aggravation, really on the verge of erupting. Just give them a machine gun and that's it. They're willing to kill everyone, and there will be such cases. So violence is the mirror of ourselves, Dr. Laitman, of what exists in each of us, yes. A person watching these surveillance videos, what can you tell them that he can be in their stead too? And the education that you're talking about, what will it do to our ego, to the savage in me? It's not the kind of education that we had where you were told, no, don't do it, it's not nice, you can go to prison. It's not that kind of education. Education means that the main thing is that the entire world, the entire nation gets a method, one method. And then you have social pressure on everyone, and therefore a person holds himself and starts improving only because of social pressure. And not because now he listens to 10 lectures.
We
finished, but if you can finish on an optimistic note? Yeah, I really hope that soon we will get serious blows that will straighten us out, take care of us, and we'll get the proper education, and we'll know how to write such articles that will also be a correct part of modern education. I really trust in you. Hug you all. Amen. Bye.
Kol tov.
תודה.